That's the wrong thing to counter, buddy. Swing in with both. We can't block, so they might just not know about this card and do no blocks, which is what we would like to see. Sweet. Finally got there. Luckily it was linear deck versus linear deck, so they didn't have much interaction, but that is exactly what the deck is supposed to do. Hey, what is up guys, Smurfy back for another video. Today we are playing a Colossal Hammer deck. So we've got Colossal Hammer, gives a creature +10/+10. We're going to go stick that on some double striking creatures. So we've got Boris Swiftblade, Swiftblade Vindicator, and Core Duelist. To find it, we've got Stoneforge Mystic, and we've got Open the Armory. And then to actually equip onto a creature, we've got Sigarda's Aid, Magnetic Theft, and wherever it is, Core Outfitter. So basically, play a creature, stick the hammer on it, try and one-shot our opponent. In the board, we've just got a bunch of different hate. So we've got creature removal, graveyard hate, burn hate, the one of Batterskull. We're not playing a main deck. Game one, we are here to do one thing, and that's hit our opponent with a hammer. And we've got some Brave the Elements if we need to get a little bit more protection. But that is the deck. Today is probably going to be a short video. I hope it is, because I do not know how I feel about this deck. Anyway, let's jump into a game. Okay, so we're on the play. That is the best place to start. We've got the creature. Yeah, we've got everything here. Sweet. Maybe this is going to be the game where we get to get the turn 3 kill. So we'll just play the 1-1. And pass the turn. Possibly it was better to play Sigarda's Aid there actually. Because then we could use the Ink Moth to try and kill on turn 3 instead. Whereas now we can't. Not on turn 3 at least. We might as well get him for one. It's not going to make much of a difference, I expect, but it's. We might as well take a Wasis there. In case our opponent gets some blockers and we get some sort of trampling damage somehow. So our opponent's got 3 mana. Oh, so we're against Infect. So I think our opponent has to block, right? So we play the Battlefield Forge. So we go Sigarda's Aid. Oh, unless our opponent's got counter magic. That's the wrong thing to counter, buddy. We just swing in with both. We can't block, so they might just not know about this card and do no blocks, which is what we would like to see. Sweet. Finally got there. Luckily it was linear deck versus linear deck, so they didn't have much interaction, but that is exactly what the deck is supposed to do. Finally happy that we got to do it. This is like, I'm currently, let me just show you on Magic Online how badly we are doing with this deck. Oh, okay, we can't. I am literally in round 4 and I went 0-2, 0-2, 0-2. So in 7 games, I've finally got a win. The deck is absolutely garbage, but it's pretty funny when that kind of stuff happens. So what do we want? Path to Exile is pretty good. And I think that's it. You can play Leyline to try and shut off Become Immense, but I think that's a waste of time. And then we're going to get rid of Apostle's Blessing, just because they don't really have much removal. Not that I've seen, at least. Yeah, let's go with that. But that was a sweet kill. Unfortunately for our opponent, they did actually have a way to stop it. So we've got the turn two Vindicator. We've got the hammer. We just don't have a way to get it onto a creature at the moment. But we've got a path to exile. We've got plenty of stuff to do. We'll keep this. It seems very counterintuitive that you have to keep this in your hand instead of casting it. So, like, normally you'd think, oh, it's one mana. We're better off doing it than doing nothing. But because of Sigarda's Age, you're actually just better off not playing it. We draw another one. We'll play the Arid Mesa here and pass. So finding the equipment is not going to be a problem this game with effectively all four in our hand. Opponent might swing in for one here. No, not going to do anything, sure. Well, we might as well get a land tapped. Play the Battlefield Forge and we'll play the one with Trample. I don't know if there's much removal they could have. They might just be playing Dismember. Sometimes aggressive decks do play Dismember just because there's only one mana and it's colourless or pseudo colourless. Okay, so they're going to boot up the Ink Moth. They're going to attack for at least two here. If they have another might, that is just lethal. Excuse me. No, but Dismember's pretty annoying for us. Okay, so they got in for a massive load of damage there. Now the problem is, if we don't draw a land... Okay, never mind. I was going to say, if we don't draw a land, what do we do? Do we keep up path or do we play a creature? Fortunately, they've answered that for us. But the Noble Hierarch does give the ability to block it this turn. Whereas if we played, I guess soaking that. Yeah, so that changes nothing for us then. There's nothing we can do. Well, there's not really any other alternative play here. So we do have to be careful if they do have some sort of protection spell or counter spell, which is pretty likely. But we will see. Dismember. I almost want to path this, but we can't. So they're going to activate the Ink Moth here and swing in. So from what I found, one of the keys to beating Infect is do not try to kill their creature during combat if you can avoid it. So now they're going to attack. We're going to take the two, and then at the end of their turn, I'm going to try and path it. Because the second that their protection spell resolves and their creature is protected, they now know they can go in with all their pump spells. Yeah, so like if I'd done it there, they could have just kicked that and just killed us. Unfortunately though, we are now just dead because of the Exalted. So let's go to the third game. So our opponent's playing quite a few Dismembers, which means I'm tempted just to ditch the Path to Exiles again, being that we're now on the play, and that one, and bring in the Apostle's Blessings. Yes, of course we do want to play first. We are just missing the equipment from this one. I'm not sure if this is worth keeping. So we've got really good mana with three dual lands and we've got plenty of creatures to put the equipment on, but we just don't have an equipment. So we've got 12 cards that we could draw, but if we don't draw one within the next three turns, we are just flat out dead. So I don't really like keeping that. Whereas this hand has got everything, so perfect. What have we got twos of? So we've got two of the hammer, two of the creature, and one of the equip. So we'll get rid of the open armory, I think. Yeah. So we'll lead off with Inspiring Vantage. into the hammer, and we'll pass the turn. So as I said earlier, we don't normally want to play the hammer, but because we've got the magnetic theft, we do want to play it. Also, we want to get around Spell Pierce. So we're going to play one of each for the one with Trample. And if they don't have Dismember, we possibly could just kill them next turn. It does rely on the fact that they don't have Spell Pierce as well, so it is fairly unlikely. I assume they drew that Wooded Foothills this turn because they led off with Waterlogged Grove, which is normally not what you'd want to do. Oh shit, they might just have the turn 2 kill. So we have to block this, unfortunately. Well, we don't have to block it, but if we don't and they have Groundswell, we die. Or double mutagenic growth, I guess, but yeah, if they have Groundswell here, we do just die. The problem is, though, if we do block, are we going to just die next turn instead anyway? Fortunately, it doesn't have Trample, so that is a big advantage at the moment. I think we do block. So the reason we're going to block is because next turn we can just play the Court Outfitter and equip the hammer on it. So that way we've got a 10-10, which is pretty hard for them to punch through. And then the turn after that we can play the Swift Blade and things. Yeah, this should be pretty hard for them to get through. Oh god, they've got Dismember. Okay. So now we probably are just dead. So they've got free reign now. If they've got a couple of pump spells, they will have enough for Become Immense. Oh, okay, that's fine. Really glad that we blocked the scale up now. So pretty much all comes down to now, do they have another removal spell? If so, then I think we're going to really struggle. But if not, we've got two Magnetic Theft. So even if they have a counter spell, that's not a problem. It's only the removal spell that we really worry about. And in fact, if it's another Dismember, we can just respond to the first one. We are going to take both here. We could block the Blighted Agent, sorry, the Glistener Elf. Because it's got first strike, but then I'll have some sort of pump spell, I expect. And I don't really want to risk it at this point. Yeah, if they let us untap, then we can play around this member, fortunately. 5, 6, sure. 7, 8. They still need one more. Okay, so that should just be game. Sweet, we finally won a round. And is it going to go back to the lead? Yeah, so we are 0-2, 0-2, 0-2, 2-1. This deck is absolutely awful. Anyway, on to the last one. See if we can squeeze another win out of the deck. So with this hand, we've got two lands, which is what we want. We've got a way to get the hammer, we've got plenty of ways to put it on, and we've got a creature to put it on, so we're going to keep this. Opponent's leading off with a Flooded Strand, sure. This is one of the slower hands with the deck. Oh, that's pretty good. Should we just go ahead and play it? Yeah, I think so. So we're going to straight away play it with the Sacred Foundry, because if we draw another land, we could just turn to Outfitter. because that might just be good enough against the white if it's like a control deck. I think we're going to go for the Swiftblade kill though. Yeah, you could definitely play this deck with green in it, with Blossoming Defense and Ancient Stirring, so I think that might be an option. So we're going to go white, red, play the Boros Swiftblade. See what our opponent's going to do. They're just going to counter it. Or they could Path to Exile. There's so many different things this deck can do. There's got so many different colours in it as well. Like, sometimes they'll be playing these plus red or plus black. It's crazy how many cards you have to try and play around. Well, that's annoying. Well, they must be scraping the barrel for lands if they're playing that on turn three with no target. So then they're just going to pass. We are going to play a Plains, and then pay double white to use the Outfitter to put it onto the Swiftblade. If they counter this, then we're just going to swing anyway, and then we'll theft at instant speed. Okay, that's fine. So yeah, now they might just not block the Swiftblade. We do have the very big upside of them just not. Most people just don't know about this card, so they could just like not block because they know it's got double strike, which they have done. And there we go, turn three kill. And people don't even see it coming. Nice. Let's see if we can steal another game against them. So against a 3-4 colored control deck, there's not really much we can board. Half of me is like, this sideboard is just dog shit because there's nothing to do with it, but the other half of me is just like, but there's not really much you can take out. Like, you've got the Apostle's Blessings, which you can take out, which is pretty good, but other than that, like, most of the deck you just can't really change. Core Firewalker is just amazing against red, as is the Batskull, and the Leyline is pretty essential against the graveyard decks. But these cards, I think, are fairly interchangeable. There's not really much you can do. In fact, I think if you played the green version, you might even just play Glistener Elf. Yeah, that could be an option. Because Glistener Elf is essentially the same as the Duelist. It's just a one drop that kills your opponent with one hit from the hammer. Okay, so we've got the turn one Duelist into the turn 2 kill. Yeah, we would definitely keep this then. I didn't even notice that we had a turn 2 kill in this deck. So you play turn 1 Duelist, turn 2 you play the hammer, instantly equip the hammer, and you hit him for 20, or 22 I guess, but yeah, that did not even occur to me that that was a play in this deck. I would also have liked to seen if this deck had Once Upon a Time In, to see how much more consistent it would have been that way, because then you can find Stoneforge, which effectively helps you find the hammer, but it also helps you find the Duelist as well, and the Outfitter, so you can find all three parts of the combo with it. Opponent's going to lead off with a tapped Breeding Pool. Okay, so for us to get the turn 2 kill, we're going to go turn 1 Duelist and hope next turn they just don't have anything to do. We're just going to play the hammer, play the thief, and hopefully that will kill our opponent. So they're going to play Field of Ruin, which means they can't play the snake. So we'll play the other Vantage, that's cool. So our opponent's probably got some sort of interaction here, I would expect. Mana Leak, okay, sure. So obviously we can't pay the mana leak. We will just swing. So next turn we can play either of these two. And then play the land and then play the card. And then we've got two ways to put it on the creature as well. Okay, so we're just drawing absolute gas. Let's go Stoneforge Mystic. So they're going to need another counterspell here, really. They are struggling on mana. So this time we're going to opt not to cast it now, because if we play it and they have mana leak, we lose it. Alternatively, if we wait till next turn, we can cast it, have mana leak mana, and then have, even if they do mana leak, the Magnetic Theft, we still have the Outfitter. So I think that's better just to try and do it next turn. Try and play around mana leak as much as possible. If they've kept a hand of only two lands, I'd expect it's going to have a lot of other types of interaction. And considering it doesn't have any card draw, we haven't really seen them do much. It must have another mana leak or something like that. Okay, that sucks. Our opponent's getting a little bit stuck on mana. So we'll play the Plains here. Tap one for the Colossal Hammer. Oh, if we want to get around counter magic, we can also use Stoneforge Mystic. Okay, so they're going to let that resolve. Pay double white to play the Outfitter. So if they counter this, we still have the Magnetic Theft, so that's fine. Yeah, sure. So that happens. Oh, no, we don't want to pay for mana leak, so no. Magnetic Theft on the Duelist, and that gives us a turn 4 win. So a little bit slower than our turn 2 that we were hoping for, and our opponent concedes. Sweet. So miraculously we managed to get 2 out of the 5, no, sorry, 2 wins to 3 losses. That deck was surprisingly fun when it works, but it is god-awful when it doesn't. Thanks for watching, guys. If you want to see more videos, feel free to subscribe, and peace.